minimum scale invariant cosmological perturbations by Shinji Mukoyama. So I'll organize this talk by first the summary of Horava Gravity. Then two, I will mention this talk that I'll be analyzing at free scale invariants. And then I'll be analyzing the number of compounds. So the first one, so the basic ingredients we'll have in the Horava Gravity is the volume element. Scaling space and time, so header come over this class. Where Z is the critical dynamical exponent, which measures the anisotropy space and time. And the spatial metric. The lapse function, the lapse, the shift vector, the lapse function, as well as the extrinsic curvature, which is so this is the covariant derivative in spatial coordinates. Talks of time derivative. So we'll be using much of the ADM measure. So this drives the kinetic potential of the kinetic. Which is pictures of a similar form above, except you'll have some contractions of functions. Schematic.
Yeah.
So this will have two space derivatives. And z equals one instead of so when we cover GR. So that's some variance. Shinji wrote has a paper on treating dark matter as a as an integral constant, which shows that we don't cover GR, we cover GR like plus dark matter. Okay. So when z equals one, which is what the regular mentioned. Hilbert action. So next, I'll be combining two and three since they are related. So we'll be running with our action when z equals 3. So in the UV, just simply 3g dx. We're going to start our metric to be a flat. Remember, I was a bunker. Space derivatives. Four derivatives. For the speed, for the field. So up here in the I of the UV, you just get this term. And then in the I of, you just get this. But we demand that variation of the speed is zero, meaning that the speed of light is constant in the IR. Okay. Now, this coefficient for this has to be positive for us to prevent any instabilities in the UV. So now, looking at the UV, so O. Is just so now we look at special cases such as sending the last function of 1 with all the shift vectors to 0, and our action here. Thank you.
differences, such as GR.
One.
We get, well, first, I'll talk about how the phi scales with the natural exponent. Simply ES phi, or S is Z minus 3. Radiation goes like times S. Cosmological energy for the Hubble expansion. So the different Zs will have different dispersion relations with the frequencies. So for Z equals 1, the dispersion relation is simply this. And when omega squared is 1 squared over Hubble squared, we'll have the mode of how I'm feeling. Experiencing the expansion of the universe. Omega squared is less than Hubble. The mode freezes. Final
perfect time mechanism in a nutshell, because it's basically quantum fluctuations. A scalar field phi being converted into curvature relations. So the curvature mechanism is mainly used for heavy particles and oscillating fields. And we'll have physical wavelengths leave the sound horizon, which is sort of like this. Spatial gradient piece here is important at and after the horizon and the IR region. So, yes. And then and the physical wavelength is only allowed to re-enter the integral mode in the mode function, which I erase converges. So, if this integral converges, this is true. Solves the horizon problem and leads to scale invariant cosmological perturbations for power law. That satisfies this. And then it's shown in other pictures by Shinji Fukuyama that Horava doesn't recover GR low energies, but it can mimic GR plus cold dark matter as an integral constant, as mentioned earlier. Other questions can arise, such as is lambda equals 1 an IR fixed point for renormalization group flow? So, is this an IR or something like that? This is current research right now. That is cool.
It's like about 20 then, so. Any questions? Nope. All right, thank you.